I want us to ask God that which He has not communicated to us that is important for our understanding that the Lord will speak this morning to us. I want us to ask the Holy Spirit to get hold of us and help us, give us the willingness and the grace to be available and obedient to what the Lord is demanding from us. Bible says, in the day of His power, the people shall be willing. I want us to say, Lord, may this day be the day of Your power that will make us to be willing to do what You want. I want us to beg the Lord not to leave us alone, not to pass us by, but to dwell with us today and help us understand Him, what He is saying and what He will continue to say even from this moment throughout today to us. And in addition to what He has already said to us since we began. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to thank God for this opportunity. Please, can you be seated? I want to thank God for this opportunity. I will be building on what already has started. My sharing this morning will be yet on the urgency of the King message. It cannot be overemphasized. In another dimension, the Lord will be bringing us in this point. And I will also share on the content of the message. Yesterday, our uncle shared about the content of the message, but that was not the whole content of the message. Another aspect of the message I will be sharing with us this morning. And I will talk about the messenger and the delivery of the message. Can you turn with me to the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8? Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8 and verse 5. Philip went down to Samaria. Before the coming of Philip, there is this man called Simon that have held the people of Samaria in bondage. He has used his magic power to make the people believe that he is a great man. He has bewitched them and held them under his control. Everyone from the least to the greatest respect him. Everyone listen to him. In fact, they assume that he is a man of God and he has the power of God. If not that Philip came, they wouldn't have believed there's any other God apart from the God of Simon. So Philip asked to go with the message. When he came to Samaria, he preached what? Christ. And when he preached Christ, Bible said that the people were healed and miracle took place. That's the content. And the people were liberated. The message of the king is to liberate the people from the bondage of Satan. And Bible said there was joy in the city. That means that the people have been without joy. You know, when the king was born and the message came to the shepherds, Bible said there was joy.
message of the king comes with the power of liberating people from bondage and gives people joy. And after he has preached and liberated people, as they paid heed to what Philip was saying, he baptized them. He initiated them to the power of the kingdom of God. You know, Jesus was trying to say the same thing to the people that are following him for bread. They were so interested and so blessed with the message of the kingdom that Jesus brought, that there are miracles, there was healings, there was prosperity, abundance, and we are just consumed by those things. And Jesus said, that was not only what the message I came for that does. Inasmuch as you are getting healed and all that, if you do not eat my flesh and drink my blood, you should not be part of me, and you will not have life eternal. They misunderstood him. Hallelujah. Men and brethren, there are many places that people are being bewitched. They are being held by men that are serving Satan. Our churches are not left out. There are people that have bewitched Christians because we refuse to study the word of God and know what God says. They are using magic powers, and they have held us that we believe that they are men of God. What do you say of a man that turned handkerchief burning with fire and also now quenched it and said, shall I prophesy? Say, prophesy, man of God. May I tell you now, shall I prophesy? Shall I prophesy? Hallelujah. That is what we have seen ourselves into. I was speaking somewhere, and somebody raised up, and I was speaking to missionaries, and somebody raised up to ask a question and said, what do we do in our place? There's this man that have come in, and he used cold water to cook egg. And the people believe that this man has anointing. I say, don't you know that that is magic? But the people believe that this man is different from this one. This one is man of God. In Lokoja, we have a man called Ozibo-Ozibo. Ozibo-Ozibo is Igbo language. That is now. Now miracle. He makes handkerchief to catch fire and quench it again and ask you to give 100 naira and plus 10 naira. And you will be a millionaire or all that. And people will come and be throwing on it. The last time he gave me was 1,000 naira. You will not know that this congregation, they have money. But when it comes to that, you will see money. There is one that is turning my stomach. That if I have chance, I will have gone to challenge him. Why is turning my stomach? That is not even anything from church. He's a Muslim in Lokoja. And he's giving people power for back to sender. I've seen many Kekinapep pasted with his picture and written power back to sender. One of the days I was returning from Manimba passing, I saw groups of people coming out with jerrycan of water from his prayer ground, both Muslims and Christians. He does yeye of Christians that go there, they put them on front in front and with Bible. He said he likes seeing them. Christians troop there. One of the days my wife was discussing with one of them that used to go there. He said, hey, that man is being used of God. A Christian. My wife said, no, man. God is not using him. They have bewitched many. They are holding many in rampage. The devil has sent them out. God is looking for the likes of Philip to confront them with the right message. The Bible says that when Philip came with the right message, it made an impact. It made a difference that the people now get to understand that Simeon is not from God. When I was listening yesterday, and the word of God was coming, and I was just looking at us. Was listening to what is coming to us. I discovered that we have not yet comprehend what God's mind is telling us. We have not yet understand where God is going. The matter that relate to the urgency of the king's message is a very critical matter. It's a very serious matter. I will take us to the Bible, to the scripture that we are going to digest very well this morning. And I'm trusting God that after we finish, God will have worked in our hearts to bring us to the level where he wants to bring us. So that we can move with him because the time is so short. You know, one of the things that you need to know is that as far as Satan is concerned, his ministry is to do what? To steal, to kill, and to destroy. Inasmuch as we are trying to reach the hidden, he too is trying to do what? To see if he can take everybody to hell. He is not wasting time as we used to waste time. Because he knew that his time is so short. And so he is doing everything he can to see if he can lead many to hell, including Christians. You know, some years ago, we don't have what we call ISIS today. There was nothing like ISIS. Some years ago, we don't have what we call Al-Qaeda today. Some years ago, there was nothing like Boko Haram. Some years ago, we don't have anything you call herdsmen. In fact, most of the herdsmen were so, you know, so friendly with the farmers in most places. Even when they have clash, it is very, very local clash, manageable. But the devil has increased his ministry. His ministry of killing and destroying. It's not only physically killing people, it's spiritually killing Christians. Ha, you are not hearing me. As it goes to kill the faith of Christians and make them to just remain redundant in the church and be useless to God and be endangered to hellfire, he goes about mobilizing suicide bombers, herdsmen, multiply. There are yet, many are yet to come because we are at the verge. In fact, when I text pastors, I told them that we are in the extra time of the injury time. You know, there used to be extra time in football. And that extra time, there's also injury time. And that is the worst time for a player. Because some wicked, wicked players, we notice those Ronaldo and Messi and what you have, to damage them and put them off from play. If not possible for life, at least for the next 2-3 matches, he will not be fielded. And sometimes it's their coach that instructs them. Target their legs. If you can remove that mess, our pursuit of making the trophy may come to pass. Hallelujah. The same thing Satan has instructed his human agents. Say, target them. You know, as he kills people who do not have Jesus, where are they going to? He is more evangelistically wicked minded, involved than us. So he goes everywhere. That's here you are studying everywhere, killing. He kills by the suicide bombers, he kills by causing an accident, plane crash, he kills by causing fire. You know, there is a lot of fire burning everywhere, a lot of death. Because he knows that if you do not kill them, very soon the Christians will do what? Will come with their message. And that message is message of what? Liberation. Go with me to the book of Romans. It is because of this that is urgent. Because that while we are sitting waiting and dallying, the devil himself is so fast killing the people, destroying the people. There was this story of a missionary who God spoke to him for a very long time. He keep parableting, struggling to answer the call and go to a people. And finally, when he yielded himself to God and went, and he entered the village with a Bible in his hand. When he came in, they saw him with a Bible. And it was the book that their fathers have told them that one day a man with a book, black book, will come. He will come with a message. You people should listen to him. So they have waited, expecting a man with a book that is black. I mean, no Bible. And the day this man arrived, they saw that book. They believed that this is the man. And the missionary started telling them. As he was telling them, the man, one of the leaders said, sorry, let me ask you a question. He said, when did God ask you to come to us? He now said, it's a long story. God has spoken to me a long time, but, you know, many things has helped me and I've tried. But finally, he said, you are wicked. The man told him, you are wicked. That not too long, my brother died. Both of us have been waiting for your coming. That our father told us that a man will come to us with a book in his hands that is black. And I and my brother have been waiting for you to bring that message. And now my brother has missed it to hear this message. Romans chapter 8 and verse 19. For the earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who had subjected the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. One day I was driving, and a malam and the chief imam of the mosque in my village, asked for lift as I saw him on the road. And I carried him. And as we are going, after Easter, he used to look for my trouble and my wife. He now triggered one question. I did as if I didn't hear it. And he and my wife was digging it. I was just driving, listening. Then it's like, this man, you must talk. I know you have something, but you didn't want to talk. So he triggered to my side. I said, now you have touched me. You will see fire. I started explaining to him, dissecting, thank you. Hallelujah. And when I was to drop him, I said, you people say you are fighting corruption. But man is more, is corrupt, no, worse corrupted than those who are fighting corruption, that are worse corrupted than those who they are fighting. I was talking from the knowledge of the scripture that everyone who don't have Christ is what? Is still under the power of what? Corruption. How can you be servant of corruption and you say you are carrying bulala? You want to fight those who are stealing money. Why the money you are stealing and what you are doing is worse than what they are doing? I think our president did not understand the English definition of corruption. I'm saying the truth. Even if I see him, that's what I would tell him. He didn't understand the English meaning of corruption. But that's not where I'm going. Bible says that the hidden has waited for the manifestation of the sons of God, because they were in bondage. Matthew chapter 9, verse 35 to 36, Bible says that Jesus left Jerusalem. He went to other cities and villages and towns, preaching in their synagogue. And when he saw the multitude, he had compassion on them, because they were what? They were fainting. They were in pains. And he said they were scattered abroad like sheep having no shepherd. That means they are potential believers if there should be pastor. They are what they are because there was no shepherd. They are waiting. They are aware that God's children carry the power for their liberation. The hidden are waiting. And I think that is why they are raging. They are fighting. That the power that was given to the church to come and liberate them, they are using it to do what? To serve themselves. The power that was given to us to go and liberate them, we are using them for our prosperity. We are sitting, making ourselves more comfortable, having AC and changing our mood of place of worship, repenting it and redecorating it. I entered a church in Lokoja that I marvel that such church is existing in Lokoja. It's wedding that carried me there. Everywhere AC. The curtain was from top to down. All windows closed. You look at the altar, you look at where Christ left. I say, wow, this is Lokoja. So the church can have money like this. And this is a man that was my friend before. I pursued to mobilize him. Suddenly, they slapped their door. Even to get him to come and preach in the day of our inauguration, the boys that shielded him didn't allow me to take my letter upstairs to give him. The hidden, they are waiting for me and you. They are not wrong if they will react that what is given to us to benefit them, we are enjoying it alone. Are you not seeing it? If a church start growing, reach to a point they say, this place is too small for us, and they will now go and buy one big place and build dome. Another person is saying, before he dies, youth leader. When I was telling him something, he said, wow, the pastor did not like to listen to me because you are cutting them down. Hallelujah. But you know, we've been flogging the church. Since yesterday I sat down, we've been flogging the church. We've been flogging pastors. And he's looking at pastors and churches that are into this issue of delaying to take the message to the church, to the hidden. Do you think that God is not expecting our parents, our Christian homes, to raise missionaries? Do you think that God is not looking onto Christian homes to raise missionaries? These sons of God we are talking about, do you think that it is only in the church that we have sons of God? The sons of God is first of all dwelling in our homes. If pastor refused to send them, what about parents? Is there anywhere that say that if a parent say, my son, go to meet missionary, join Capro, that God will say, no, I don't want, it's not coming from church. Your pastor did not approve it. If I waited for my pastor's approval, I wouldn't be here. My pastor was grooming me to be in the headquarters. From the village operation, he noticed that I'm a missionary and he knew Capro, and he didn't want to connect me. He knew I'm a missionary. My ministry in the village was so clear. And one day like that, he made a mistake to bring some Butu to our church. And I was sitting there listening. And when some Butu finished, that is where I got to know the name Capro. If not, where I was in my village ministry, where will I know about Capro? And I approached him, I said, I want to go to this Capro. Please give me the direction to Josh. He said, okay, I'm traveling. When I come back, I will do that. But the fire became so much that I couldn't wait for him to return from Kenya, that I carried my bag, started looking for Capro. That was my second time of coming to the north. I dropped at Terminus. And then my blankets as bed. And suddenly I saw one mad person. I shifted ground. When it became morning, I started. Those days, you can't even get Capro anyhow. They don't have signboard. No signboard. I mean, 1989. I started looking for Capro, asking questions from one church to another. They weren't even so known then in Capro Church. Then I went around, so I met somebody. Said, oh, I know one of the missionaries is living in a flame church. I carried Okada go there. He said, he has gone to war. they give description of UMCA compound. And they carried me and I reached there. It didn't look like the name I'm hearing. And the man that came to shake us. It looks like a residential area. I said, man, please wait here. If it's not them, you will carry me again. As I entered, the first person I saw was Ego Mubuko, our beloved sister, late Ego Mubuko, and Sister Ronti. I met them. To cut the long story short, I was given direct entrance. And I landed in Peter Zodo's house. They say, are you married? I say, I know I'm married. Are you intending to marry? Well, the thing is getting somehow. Because I prayed God, I want to marry and I want to go to missions. The person that I want to marry, see her there. It's not agreeing immediately. I say, okay, it is not marriage now. Let me go to missions. Maybe the wife is there. And I went. I said, that is it. The next thing they saw me when I left is in ADG Jaran Kogi. It's not even this one, Jaran Kogi. And they saw me with their wife. Say, ah, you told us. He said, that. So God do I. As I just go here, now double blessing. Door was opening. Hallelujah. Brethren, let me ask us, what effort are you making in your house to give God a missionary among your children? Do you know that many of us have been resisted by our parents? Some came back and say, Mom, Dad, God is telling me to be a missionary. I say, God forbid. For us to invest in you, for these 4 years, you say you want to waste your life. You want to waste your life? Every life must be wasted. I better waste it in the will of God. Jesus said, if you will give your life to God's will, you will do what? You will gain it back. But if you will not, you will lose it. Last year, as they give charge on missions and call people to come, my daughter joined them and came out. After somebody came and said, hey, I said, I'm not surprised. I'm even expecting more. Because from childhood in devotion, I teach that. A few days ago, I was driving with her and I said, how about this matter? She said, Dad, I'm not going to do missions like you. I said, by the way, will you do mission like me? If you do mission like me, then that's an error. Because your age, when I started mission, there was no handset. There was no internet. In fact, I know that brother Peter suffered to transfer money to people in Senegal. Hunger was killing them. It was difficult to carry the money to go and give them. Pay transport and stay many days to reach them with money. Brother Padeto Kun was already in terrible situation when the money got him. And this money had been with him for many days. Is it like that today? So why should you say you would do mission like us? That if you have to send money to a missionary in the field, you have to travel with the money. The risk of armed robbers. So I'm not even expecting you to say you would do mission like me. After all, my father was not a missionary. He's not even a Christian till now. So you have a better background that your father is a missionary. And I started from childhood to teach you about mission. I kneel down and pray, God, call my children to different ministries. Send them. A man that is serving Satan, when he's getting old, he will look for a replacement. Agents of Satan never die with the power of Satan they are holding. They transfer it to one of their child. And we are the ones that don't know what we are carrying. We think that calling our children to serve God as missionaries is wasting their life. And all this while, we have been complaining and pointing hand on pastors. while we ourselves are wearing the same shoe. Some have cursed their child because he said God is calling him to be a missionary. What I think God is saying to us, that every Christian family must produce a missionary for him. Every husband and wife that is Christian must go home and start praying and asking God, who among our children? Even don't tell me that you have only one. Abraham had only one. And God said, sacrifice it to me. He didn't query God. He said, Abba, God. Abba, we don't pass that level. You know how many years it took me and you to produce this child? Why are you doing this to me? Okay, God promised me that you will give me another one. You know one thing I love Abraham, I love Isaac. Even when his father carried the dagger, Isaac was looking at him. Isaac was so smart that he would have slipped out of Abraham's hand and jumped out from the altar and run away and say, God, is that how wicked my father is? Isaac would have said to his father, even if God says you should kill me, can't you tell him that you love me? That you can't part away with me. But Isaac said, let the will of my father. He has a kind of Christ in him. Let's leave pastors alone. Let's leave church alone. If church has failed God, we parents, will we also join them? Do they say that if you disciple your child and send him to missions, they will discommunicate you from church? Even some of us parents, we are elders in the church. We are deacons in the church. When we finish here now, we go back. We will sit under them. We will join all the activities they list without questioning some things. Next year, we come back. We hear the same challenge. We go back. Let me ask you, have you not been discipled enough to jump out and say, God, here am I? What is keeping you? You are waiting to marry. You are waiting to get children. One man, God called him. And he said he wants to get enough money before going to ministry. And he started working hard to be a principal of a school. For years, he ended to be a vice principal. And was very old. We have been wasted in trying to gather money until the day he arrived in Boko. As Billy was speaking, he didn't even know what he's speaking. And he's pointing hand. And what he's saying is about that man. And he's pointing hand as if he knew the man. When it became too much, the man got up and said, can I go now? Sir, he came out, said, can I go now? Bile was aback and looked at him, said, what I have done to you? Say, you've been talking and pointing hand to me, even. The thing was so real. And, for years I've been busted into it. Say, oh, sorry. You will be a liability in the mission field. Where have you been all this while when your youthful strength was there? These are our youths. We have engaged them in chorography, dancing. They enter music, football, drama, comedy. All that is what our youth is so much having anointing to do. And I ask pastors, are there not any one of them that are called to be apostles? Is it only this that they have received grace to do inside church, year in and year out, not going anywhere? Are there not some of them that are called to be evangelists, like in the days we came to know God? Nobody again among our youth will come out and say, God is calling me to be an evangelist or pastor or this or that. Even those who say they are pastors, they like to go to where there is money and establish their ministry where they will make more money. And they will make themselves, their mentors will be those frontline men of God. When I was speaking in local, I said, I was telling them, God must give me my own jeep, jet, as I have given my mentor. It's 1 year that he just started ministry. He's dreaming of a jet. A young person. My brothers and sisters, I think that the climax of what God is saying to us this morning and in this meeting, and what God is saying is that church, yes, is not so much into mission. Pastors are not interested in mission. But what about parents? What about our homes? Are we also going to fail God? Are you also going to fail God? Some of you have been in discipleship 10 years, 20 years. Have you not been disciple enough to carry the message? When Absalom died, David was waiting for message to come to him from the field. And here comes this man from Africa. And Job said to him, take a message to the king, because the man has seen and understood what has happened. But there's this young man also who used to carry message. But that day was not his turn to carry message. He said, I want to run. Let me so go. He said, you have no message. Don't run. This is man that will run today. When the man started running, follow the right way with the message. He said, Oga, let me run. My legs are asking for run. He said, but you don't have message. He said, no way. I have some stories to tell, some stories. It's okay, run. He cut corner. He followed shortcut. And it outran the man that has the message. And when he was coming, the watchman saw him and said, oh, here come Ahimaaz. Running, coming. David said, yes, if it's Ahimaaz, he has a message. Only to be disappointed when Ahimaaz arrived and started to purpose. I said, please set aside. There are people that we need to do to set them aside. They are telling people fables in the church. Some will tell you how they went to Jerusalem. Our pastor those days went to Jerusalem and returned and gave birth to the last born and gave him Tel Aviv. And he said that they went to one toilet that he didn't know how to flush the toilet. We had to press him. It was preaching from the altar. And the people get fed up with all his stories. Anytime he go for PFM meeting, now that is going to be the message. So they say, go by the side. Since another person is coming, we have hope. Brethren, the nations have hope for you that are here. Some of you have returned from MLR, you are here. You have been discipled, they are here, we are discipling you, we are pushing mission into you. What will you make of it again? When you live here, is it to go and sit again and attending discipleship? It has become a routine, a program. You have never discipled anybody. It's always been discipled. And James said, when you're supposed to be a teacher, you needed someone to do what? To be teaching you. For how long? Jesus only discipled them 3.5 years and did what? And send them. Discipleship without mission is something else. When you are discipled, you must not be a perfect human being before you become a missionary. Anybody that is telling you that is deceiving you. But you must get the message so that you can deliver it correctly. The message, when this man came and he gave the message, it was sharp. It was personalized. It was persuasive. When Jesus spoke to the woman on the well, do you know what happened? Because the message was personalized, the woman dropped her ambition of fetching water and went back to carry the message to the house. And the whole place was shaking. When Peter gave the message, it was what? Personal, persuasive, and powerful. 3,000 people say, "We have heard you. Stop going far. All you have said is enough. Tell us the next agenda, the next level." The next level is repent and do what? And accept this thing. It is for you and your sons. When Paul preached this message to Agrippa and Governor Felix, it was a different dimension, but there was impact. Agrippa said, "Paul, do you think that in this short time you can succeed in persuading me to be a Christian?" He used the word persuasion, because that was how the message hit him. My brothers and my sisters, are you going to yet continue disappointing God? God needs a person. God needs us. Say, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" It means that there are people that are God, but not for God. Will you continue sitting like this and seeing your father's vineyard full of grass with him? Among us, as I round up with this story, our brother Nigbade, Uncle Nigbade, used to tell us that even at that time he was 20-something, now he must have been 30-something in mission years. He said he is still waiting for the call of God. That God did not call him, "Hey, bro, Nigbade. Bro, Nigbade. Come and be missionary and I will send you to Ghana Woody place." He said he saw a need. Have you not seen a need? What are you still waiting? God may not call you and your name and say, "Go to Kanuri." But he may open your eyes to do what? To see a need. Jesus saw and had compassion on them. What are you still waiting? I think that is the heart of God to us this morning. Can we pray? Shall we bow our heads? Respond to God. I don't know what God has said to you in this short sharing, but I believe that God is saying something to his people. And nothing but, "I need your cooperation. I need your commitment." You need to take your commitment to God to the next level. We are in next level governance. Take your commitment to God. Especially we parents, we need to go back home and start preaching missions to our children. Start discussing this important issue with our children. Give God a missionary from your home. You are blessed. Timothy was produced from home. It was not Paul that made him. Can you say, "God, help me. Help me. I want to go back and do this thing that you are saying this morning. I want to go back and look again on my commitment to this whole important subject. Help me to teach my children. Help me to mobilize my family. Not just to be giving also, but to see how we can release people. Both your children and people that God has given you in the course of evangelism or whatever. I have them. 26, 27, I had meeting with my family. We are telling them, you are not just going to school to get a job, and you are going to school so that you will be prepared for ministry. That was what I told them. And I met those who have returned among Basa people who are our converts that came to do Christmas with me. I called them and said, you are finished you are university education. You are a master's. You are a medical person. You are here. Now it is time for you to pay attention to missions. We must be mobilizers, mobilizing anywhere we are, everywhere we are, and engaging people in missions. If this mission is important